Okay, hello all. In this session, I'm going to explain about parallelogram law of forces and polygon law of forces. Okay, these law of forces, after solving, deriving this, derivation, upon this we have a problems also. Here, the first I'll go with the statement. This law is applicable to determine the resultant of two coplanar concurrent forces only. So here you can see to find, see this two are forces, this is your resultant force, right? This is F1, this is F2 and this is R. So this law of force is mainly determine the resultant of two coplanar concurrent forces. Coplanar concurrent means the forces which acts in the same plane and also acts from a same point. So that is your concurrent forces. So this law states that if two forces acting at a point are represented both in magnitude and direction by the two adjacent sides of the parallelogram, then the resultant of these two forces is represented both in magnitude and direction by the diagonal of the parallelogram passing to the same point. See here you can see two forces are acting from the same point. First these two forces we are going to join. So this is be happening as a parallelogram, and one diagonal is passing. This is a diagonal, so we are considering as a R. Okay, from the same point. Okay, so the angle for this is F1 and F2. The angle we are taking as theta between the F1 and F2, and F1 and R we are taking as alpha here. So here, if you join this, we are getting the triangle. So that is F2 cos theta and vertically F sine theta, and the angle will be this one theta. Next, so first we will see the introduction for the figure. That is, let F1 and F2 be the two forces acting at a point and theta be the angle between them. Let OA and OB represent forces F1 and F2. Here you can see OA F1 and OB F2 represent respectively both in magnitude and direction. The resultant R of F1 and F2 can be obtained by completing a parallelogram with OA and OB. So this one we are going to complete. So we are getting a parallelogram as a adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So adjacent side we got, adjacent means all the four adjacent sides we got, and the diagonal OC of the parallelogram represents the resultant R. This is the diagonal OC. This is a diagonal OC of a parallelogram represents the resultant R, both magnitude and direction. Okay, so from the figure, OC is equal to root of OD square plus CD square. So already we know this formula, that basic formula. AC is equal to root of AB square plus CB square. So root of OD. What is OD? Here you can see OD means OA plus AD. OA plus AD square whole square plus CD square as usual. This is your CD square. Okay, so what is OA plus AD square? So here you can see OA plus AD square means, here you can see F1 plus F2 cos theta whole square plus what is CD? See this, CD is F2 sin theta square. So totally we are getting OC means already we know that is R. OC. So R is equal to root of F1 square plus F2 square. I'm applying A square plus B square plus 2AB. F1 square plus F2 square plus 2 into F1 into F2 into cos theta. So we are calling this as an equation number 1. Equation number 1. So here you got the magnitude for the resultant. Next we will see the angle for this. That is, let alpha be the inclination of the resultant with the direction of the F1. Then alpha is equal to tan inverse of F2 sin theta divided by F1 plus F2 cos theta. So here you can see here, that is, tan theta is equal to what? sine theta divided by cos theta. So here you can see this is opposite divided by adjacent. So the angle will be f2 sine theta, that is vertically, and f1 plus f2 cos theta means adjacent. So that's what tan inverse into f2 sin theta divided by f1 plus f2 cos theta. So this will be equation number 2. Equation number 1 gives the magnitude of the resultant, and equation 2 gives the direction of the resultant force. Here you can see f1 gives the magnitude, and next one, equation 1, equation 2 gives the direction. So direction means the angle. So equation 2 gives the direction of the resultant force. So here we are taking in the different cases of the parallelogram, just we are changing the theta. For different values of theta we have different cases. So first one, theta is equal to 90 degree. If your theta is 90 degree, here you can see if your theta is 90 degree, okay, so r is equal to root of f1 square plus f2 square, that we already know, that is fx square plus fy square. So alpha will be tan inverse of f2 by f1. Next, if theta is 180 degree, see here you can see the theta is 180 degree. This is 0, if I write like this is 0, 90, 180, 270, 360, right? The same way, when theta is equal to 180 degree, so r is equal to f1 minus f2, alpha will be 0, no angles for that, right? See, this one, f1 is positive, f2 is negative. So theta will be 0 because forces are in the same line, so no angle for that. Case 3, that is when theta is equal to 0 degree, no angle, 0. So r is equal to f1 plus f2, so alpha is equal to, as usual, 0 degree, and f1, f2, this is also plus, this is also plus. So that's why r is equal to f1 plus f2, alpha is equal to 0. Okay, next one, polygon law of forces. What is polygon law of forces? If a number of concurrent forces, what is concurrent forces? Concurrent forces means the forces pass from same point. Okay, forces passes from same point. If a number of concurrent forces acting simultaneously on a body are represented in magnitude and direction by the sides of the polygon, take it in order, then the resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by the closing side of polygon taken in opposite order. Okay, here you can see that we are having so many number of forces. We have some number of forces here, right? This one. 1 minute. We have number of forces. So here you can see F1, F2, F3, F4. So all the forces I'm just writing continuously like this. F1, F2, F3 and F4 like this. So we are closing this loop. Right, closing these loops. So this closing the polygon completely. The law says that if a number of concurrent forces acting simultaneously on the body represented magnitude and direction by the sides of a polygon, take it in order. So for example, this force represent this like this. Okay, so all the forces acting continuously and closing the loop in the resultant is represented in magnitude and direction by closing. So this, you are closing the loop. So this diagonals act as a resultant forces. So this is called as polygon law forces. Okay. Thank you.